Hi, everybody, friends of the GoTo Foundation. My name is Luis Raez. I'm the medical director of Memorial Cancer Institute. I am a lung cancer doctor. It's a pleasure to share with you briefly about what is immunotherapy and if it's for me. Basically, the immune system is the one that defends us against microbes, any type of infection, and also the same thing as the cancer. And our immune system is fighting every single day since you were born to keep us away from these infections or cancers. However, there is something in the immune system that is not well understood yet that makes, for example, the immune system to fail against lung cancer. When the lung cancer is growing inside our body, the immune system is not defending us. The immune system is allowing these tumors to grow in our lungs and other parts of our body. And sometimes they are not attacking these tumors or they are attacking unsuccessfully. So the idea of the immunotherapy that we do now for lung cancer is to revamp your immune system, to enhance the immune system so our own immune system can attack these threats and in this particular case, lung cancer. So basically that's what we do. Our immune system is not working very well because there is a break. In the immune system, always there is a balance between activating the immune system or to break the immune system. And that balance needs to be done because otherwise our immune system will attack us, causing diseases like lupus, arthritis rheumatoid. So that is why when the immune system is not working and the lung cancer is proliferating, is because there is a break. For that reason, what we need to do is we need to use something that we call anti-PD-1 or anti-PD-L1 antibodies, that basically what they do is they release the brake of the immune system and allows our immune system to get a strength and to attack the cancer by itself. Yeah, a lot of times that's the difference between chemotherapy and immunotherapy that we use. The immunotherapy that we use does not attack directly the cancer. The immunotherapy releases this brake that we have, and our own immune system is going to go and attack the cancer. Yeah. There are many advantages or disadvantages of this. Maybe some of the disadvantages, this is new technology. So please don't think that one infusion immunotherapy is going to cure your lung cancer. We are just in the beginning, in the first 5 to 10 years. So hopefully we will make it much more efficient in the future. We still have to figure it out. Why in some patients immunotherapy works very well and other patients don't work very well. For example, we use a marker called PD-L1, and apparently if we have the marker, the immunotherapy may work better than if we don't have the marker, but we need much better markers to have one day that we diagnose your lung cancer, we give immunotherapy, and we can reassure you that you will get cured. But we are in the process. In the meantime, we use immunotherapy after surgery. We use immunotherapy now before surgery with chemo. We use immunotherapy after your chemotherapy and radiation. And as you know, we use chemotherapy and immunotherapy for patients with metastatic disease. So the use of immunotherapy is very popular in lung cancer. I hope it's going to keep only increasing. But little by little, I think we're going to make it better, more efficacious, less toxic, so the patients can benefit more and more. For now, more than 90% of our patients have side effects that are tolerable, like a mild rash, mild diarrhea, some bone pain, joint pain. And we need to monitor the liver function test, the kidney function test, and a lot of other parameters in the body of the patient to be sure that there is not an excessive inflammation with the release of the immunotherapy. And that is why when we see sometimes in less than 5% of the patients, some colitis, pneumonitis, and other reactions that the doctor monitors to try to prevent them. So in general, it seems to be safe, but however, it needs to be monitored closely by clinical symptoms and, as I said, laboratory tests. So it's an area very exciting for us. So hopefully we will have more to talk about this soon as more developments for immunotherapy are coming. Thanks for listening.